Her im Hochgebirge am
When you're moving over glaciers in high mountain terrain, you need to master the techniques for rescuing partners as well as for self-rescue. There are two techniques for self-rescue: the Prusik technique, which enables you to climb back up a rope, and the self-pulley technique, which is used to haul yourself back up over the lip of a crevasse. If you fall into a crevasse and need to rescue yourself, you are going to need some basic equipment. This includes two accessory cords, carabiners, and to make things easier, a rope clamp. Self-rescue is a whole lot easier with ascending devices, ideally a Micro Traxion and a Tibloc, or a basic ascender, Jumer. The ascenders are then used instead of Prusiks. One of the best functions of these ascenders is that you can easily move them around any brake knots tied in the load line. As always, the first step in a self-rescue procedure using ascenders is to set up your personal anchor, your body Prusik. The Tibloc, or basic ascender, is simply fixed to the rope. Then using a 90-centimeter sling, adjusted to arm's length, and clipped in to set up your personal anchor. The basic is then clamped to the rope above and serves as your personal anchor. Next, you need to create your climbing Prusik. To do this, take the Micro Traxion, place it below the upper rope ascender, and clip in a foot loop or sling. Now you can begin to climb the rope, pushing upwards first on the personal anchor, then the lower ascender, then a step up, and so on. A different technique is used to get over the lip of the crevasse, the self-pulley technique. Here you clip the Micro Traxion to the harness, remove the foot loop, and by using the reverse lock mechanism of the Micro Traxion, you hook the rope through the top clamp and the self-pulley is complete. Using the pulley through your harness to redirect the rope, you massively reduce the friction you would otherwise get with a garde hitch. Self-rescue using the Prusik technique or a self-pulley is not difficult, but it needs to be practiced, ideally at home or even on a climbing wall. That way, you will be well equipped to undertake high alpine tours, both big and small.